Well, Josh, Jen, we're outside the family's home right now in Rochester. And even though James Foley has been missing for 41 days now, the family just went public this morning with his kidnapping. Now, a few details are being released, but the family and his employer say government agencies are helping to work to bring him back home. James Foley's mother had no comment at the family's Rochester home Wednesday evening as family and friends wait for word from Syria. On James's website Wednesday morning, the family posted a letter saying he was kidnapped by unidentified gunmen on Thanksgiving Day in Syria. They also launched FreeJamesFoley.org, where they're asking for the public's support for his release. This is the second time the international conflict journalist has been kidnapped while reporting overseas. In early 2011, he was taken captive in Libya with several other journalists. One member of the group was killed, but Foley and the others were released after several weeks. In Libya and now in Syria, James worked with the website Global Post. The site's founder released a statement saying, "Over the past nearly 6 weeks, we have been working intensively with many parties in the United States and in the Middle East to secure Jim Foley's freedom so he can return home to his loving family. We urge his captors to release him." The danger of reporting during violent conflicts was something Foley understood. And when we talked to him following his release in 2011, he said it was something he was prepared to face again.
"Yeah, I'm blessed. I feel good and ready to go back in and, be smarter and, realize that it's, be anonymous again and write and shoot the story, rather than accidentally becoming the story."
Now, we've also heard from Senator Jeanne Shaheen tonight, who assisted the family during the 2011 kidnapping. In a statement, she has said she personally reached out to a number of agencies, including the State Department and the FBI, requesting any additional support they can provide. Senator Kelly Ayotte said she is also actively assisting the Foley family and is in close contact with the State Department regarding James's status. Now, there's also been a Facebook page set up for James Foley, hoping that his release comes soon. That's the latest from Rochester tonight. Melinda Davenport, WMUR News 9.